Junkfoodtaster.com, episode 3461. Yeah, it's time for milk chocolate, and it's something really special. It's a Fort Knox gold bars. Alright, comes in this, yeah, interesting tray or something. So it's a back side. And Fort Knox is of course in the USA, and I think it's also an American product. But look at this, it's made in Holland. So, yeah, kind of interesting or something. okay, so this is sort of chocolate gold, and I sort of also got chocolate money. And yeah, when I'm starting sort of the random chocolate reviews, I was just thinking let's review these as well. This is like merchandise for, yeah, East German, old school, yeah, sort of animation stuff. Sandman. Okay, guys, but yeah, let's check out the Fort Knox first. And must open somehow in the game. Yeah. And then we can take them out separately. Or all at once. Okay, little gold bars. Let's do this. I always wanted to put a gold bar. And first I strip it. Okay, it's three little gold bar doesn't look like this, but anyways. you can always cut stuff. Oh. Cutting fail. Yeah. So yeah, some air is inside. So it was not completely useless or something. Yeah. So I'm eating the Fort Knox gold bar. I'm just waiting that this issue or something. Tastes cheap. But this is now more like these are all fun products. Whereas like these are packaging products basically. What is this here? Yeah, you may know it, East Germany was a communist country. And so this is sort of a contradiction on its own. This is the money bills from East Germany, from a communist country. They have money in communism. Not really, but... yeah, and let me know whether you recognize any of these characters. It's not characters, it's actually real people who really live. I guess some of you may... This guy here on the 100 mark bill. Maybe also this one. If you know a little bit about Germany, you know him. But anyways. And this is the same thing. It's also milk chocolate. Yeah, this is sort of really old school packaging with aluminium foil. Yeah. Like the Fort Knox, it's sort of unspectacular. Yeah, no pattern, nothing. No. Yeah, okay. You can eat this basically, but it's, yeah, it's the same rating, fun rating. Okay. Anyways, now comes the Sandman. This is sort of an animated stuff. There's children, like, the last. Back in the day, there were only two TV channels, and this was a program for children. And this was when they should go to bed, basically, the Sandman. Okay. Here we go. Okay, it's broken. Okay, we have some sort of pattern on here. Let's get the unbroken one. Here's some gift ribbon or something. But not Sandman related. Okay. Oh. Here's sort of flying in a suitcase, a flying suitcase. Then here's driving a white book, which is a communist car. Yeah, here is like flying here in some Islamic country or something. Yeah, flying on the carpet, the carpet flyer. Here's some more. I guess I unbox this as well. What's he doing here? Like feeding a rabbit, I don't know. Here we got, this is from a series. So this is Schnatterinchen, Moppel, and in the middle is Pity Plutch. Yeah. Anyway, here we got like Pity Plutch. Yeah, you can cut this out and you have Pity Plutch for balloons. Alright. Yeah. Here we got a unicorn. So like back in the day, there was also unicorns. And he is feeding the unicorn the carrot. Okay. So my friends, it's over. I hope you enjoyed this review. yeah, do buy such products from time to time, like fun packaging products, didn't they? And thank you. Gut, jetzt gibt es hier Schokolade. Und zwar einmal hier Fort Knox. Interessant, also. Das ist Fort Knox, Goldbahn. Interessanterweise in Holland hergestellt, aber es ist tatsächlich für den amerikanischen Markt gedacht, so ist es nicht. Okay. Ja, gibt es weiter nicht zu sagen. Der schmeckt mir fast besser als diese Sandmann-Dinger hier. Dann habe ich noch den Sandmann. Genau. Richtig oldschool. So wie es sein muss. Hier moppeln. Genau. Und dann habe ich noch das Geld. Im englischen Teil habe ich gesagt, Communist Country, das wird halt so gesagt. In England, die haben da, oder in Amerika, die wissen nicht so richtig, die haben kein Wort für Sozialismus, ist ja egal. Und das ist halt aus das Geld aus der DDR, jedenfalls, beziehungsweise so sieht der Schein halt aus. Den hat man halt jetzt in der Verpackung umgestaltet. So, auf dem 20er war Goethe drauf, zumindest 1975. Dann, das müsste Clara Zetkin sein. Genau, auf dem 10er war eine Frau drauf. Dann auf dem 50er ist Engels. Ist doch Engels, oder? Ja, Friedrich Engels, steht doch drauf. Dann haben wir Thomas Münzer auf dem 5er. Und auf dem 100er, den habe ich ausgepackt, glaube ich. Wo ist er hin? Auf dem 100er ist Marx. Ich weiß gar nicht, ob es noch höhere Scheine gibt. Genau, da wird sich der Herr Marx freuen. Der Mann, der das Geld abschaffen wollte, ist auf Geld ein drauf. Okay. Ja, und hier ist halt dann hier absolute Kultcharaktere mit Pity Platsch und Moppel und Schnatterinchen. Ja, genau. Gut. Das ist halt so Kult, Fun. Ja. Also jetzt geschmacklich oder produktmäßig jetzt nicht unbedingt die Welt, gar nicht. Aber ist halt sozusagen so, so als Geschenk oder so. Ja. Okay, das wär's soweit. Danke, dass ihr zugesehen habt und bis zur nächsten Folge.